welcome to your 5 minutes with Seatrade Cruise, your roundup of the week's top stories today brought to you by our sponsor, the Port of Tarragona. As we record this, the US-based cruise industry is anxiously awaiting news on the country's no sail order, which is due to expire at the end of October. When the order was made in September, the White House was alleged to have overruled CDC Chief Robert Redfield's argument for extending it through February. Some major US-based cruise lines are now optimistically gearing up for a return to sailing by the end of the year. December departures from Port Miami are listed on Carnival's website for Carnival Sunrise and Carnival Conquest, and from Port Canaveral for Carnival Liberty and Carnival Elation. Three of the big four cruise companies, MSC Cruises, Carnival Corporation and PLC, Royal Caribbean Group and Hapag-Lloyd Cruises, now have experience resuming operations in Europe. Coronavirus cases and hospitalizations are on the rise stateside, but CLIA argues that the US is losing 800 jobs for every day the industry shut down. The Healthy Sail Panel claims protocols, not community infection levels, should inform the decision on whether to allow cruising to resume. Costa Smeralda has successfully completed its first LNG bunkering operation in Italy at the port of La Spezia. Bunkering vessel Coral Methane was positioned alongside Costa's first LNG-powered vessel while it was berthed at Molo Garibaldi Pier. The event marks Costa Group's 50th bunkering operation. Tom Strang, Senior Vice President of Maritime Affairs at Carnival, said the cruise line is working to build an extensive, safe and reliable LNG infrastructure for cruise ships around the globe. Carla Roncallo, President of the Port Authority of Eastern Ligurian Sea, and Franco Porcellaccia, Costa Group's Sustainable Innovation and Infrastructure Development Vice President, described the bunkering as a milestone both for Italy and the port. Sticking with Costa Cruises, the company will send its new LNG vessel, Costa Toscana, to South America for the 2021-2022 season along with Costa Favolosa. It follows the line choosing not to operate a 2020-21 South America season, a blip in its seven-decade history there. Three ships had originally been planned for the region. Dario Rustico, Costa's general manager for Central and South America, said, "The debut in Brazil of our most innovative ship strengthens the special 72-year-long bond between Costa Cruises and South America." The 180,000 gross ton ship is currently under construction. It will leave Brazil in April 2022, crossing to Italy on April 17th. Starting November 20th next year, Favolosa will spend 144 days in South America, the longest stretch in Costa's history. For its Europe sailings, Costa has blocked passengers from countries with COVID-19 infection rates higher than Italy's from sailing on board its ships. Dream Cruises World Dream has arrived in Singapore carrying 187 crew members as it prepares to resume operations from there starting November 6th. The crew completed a 14-day quarantine prior to the arrival and will undergo a further series of COVID tests before sailing. Additional crew will be required to test negative before signing on for active duty. Dream Cruises recently pledged to fill vacancies on the ship with mostly Singaporeans. The short cruises to nowhere are restricted to Singapore residents only. Royal Caribbean International's Quantum of the Seas is also set to begin sailing from Singapore at the end of the year. Princess Cruises' biggest 2020-21 season in Australasia has been interrupted, with the company deciding to pause all cruises there until May 31st. It had planned to debut the 3,560-passenger Regal Princess in Sydney from December until April. Regal Princess was also to have joined sister ship Majestic Princess for a program of voyages to New Zealand and the South Pacific. The cruise line's senior vice president for Asia Pacific, Stuart Allison, said it would have been the first time in history that Princess Cruises had deployed two Royal Class ships from the same home port outside of Florida. And finally, congratulations to Valeria Mangiarotti, who will take up the role of MedCruise Senior Vice President from the end of this month, and Nick Stace, who has been named the new CEO at Saga Travel. Stace will head up Saga's cruise and tours portfolio with immediate effect. Thanks again to the Port of Tarragona, which celebrates its 150th anniversary until November 20th. Visit tarragonacruiseport.com or porttarragona.cat to find out more about the gateway to the UNESCO World Heritage City and the Mediterranean, and check out their video. Thank you for watching.